What's going on, Masterminds, and welcome back to Mastar Media. Today, we're going to be talking about Dragon Ball Super Episode 120 as Universe 3 makes their move and has a final stand against Universe 7. Now, before I start breaking down all of the little elements that happen in this episode, I first just want to say that the art was really, really good in this episode. And I know because whenever I'm trying to pick a thumbnail and I'm just scrolling through the episode, taking screenshots, there was literally like over 30 different pictures to use for this episode. And as I actually watched it three times, and every time I watch it, I realize more and more how good the art was. I think partly this is due to Shimonuki being an animation supervisor. He's actually one of my favorite Dragon Ball artists, did some fantastic work on Dragon Ball Z, and I felt like because of him, this episode really shined. But unfortunately, even though the art was spectacular in this episode and we actually had some really good animations as well, I didn't really feel like the story writing was that strong, especially because these three robots who got smacked around by Cauliflaw like they were absolutely nothing, Cauliflaw's base form in episode 112, now all of a sudden are putting the heat on Universe 7, and Goku and Vegeta and just about everybody is getting blasted away by these three super weak robots. And I was kind of like, you know, this is classic Dragon Ball Super. They make these weak characters strong all of a sudden. And fortunately for us, that didn't last too long. Our boy Gohan steps up to the plate like a freaking boss, and he totally just takes on all three of these machines by himself. There's some really nice shots of Gohan there. He really stepped up and basically kicked all of their asses pretty much by himself, which was nice. I'm always happy to see Gohan. I'm a huge Gohan fan. I'm always happy to see him take more of a leadership role, take more of an aggressive role in terms of battle and things like that, and see him kick some butt. And he totally did in this episode, which, at least for me, at being a Gohan fan, was extremely satisfying. Now, we also got to see the androids take on this guy. His name's like Viagra or something like that. And it was pretty good. It was a pretty cool fight. You know, one of the funniest things about that fight to me was they actually won by using machine gun blasts. Like, you guys know the TFS joke when, you know, they're like, when does that even work anyway? Because, like, usually in Dragon Ball, shooting machine gun blasts does absolutely nothing. And here, 1718 actually won a fight by doing that. It was a pretty cool scene. It was well animated, just seeing them battle, the two androids working in cohesion together. Again, they're proving how strong they are as a duo. And it was nice to see them take out this guy nice and early without taking any damage. You know, he was tough. He's made out of some solid kind of metal. He's got the most defenses in the whole universe. And, you know, he was a tough guy, but Android 1718 stepped up, kicked his butt with some machine gun blasts. That was also satisfying to watch. After Gohan beats them all up, Moscow, God Destruction of Universe 3, initiates Plan X, which is basically to fuse these three guys. Now, it looks like Papyroni, they call him Dr. Papyroni in this episode, it looks like he is the creator of these three robots. He's basically like Universe 3's Dr. Gero. And we all know, after all of Dr. Gero's inventions, basically what his capabilities are, you have any other doctor that's in charge of some robots, I mean, you got to be scared that there's going to be something probably coming out that's a little bit terrifying. The three robots merge and everybody's all scared and everything. Even Jiren, I want to say he's raising an eyebrow here, but he's even staring it down like this is some kind of threat. But as we saw later down the episode, these guys weren't really a threat at all, at least not yet. Now, interesting how Frieza is still just like, I'm going to hang out on this mountain and watch everything go down. I mean, he is really avoiding battle at all costs at this point. He doesn't want to fight anybody strong. He's just waiting for his opportunity here to make his snaky move and get whatever he really wants. Well, what he wants is manipulation of the gods. But what I'm wondering is, like, when is this actually going to happen? Like, when is this double crossing coming? They keep giving us these hints about Frieza throughout the episodes that, you know, he's going to make his move at some point. He's still at this current time just sitting there waiting. My favorite part about the entire episode was when Vegeta turns Super Saiyan Blue and Goku and turns Super Saiyan Blue and Gohan powers up and you have this trinity of Saiyans. It was super, super awesome. It kind of reminded me of the Trinity of Super Saiyans coming out of movie 7. I mean, that was super epic when we had it back then. And here, even though Gohan doesn't have Super Saiyan Blue, his power is way up there. I mean, I would say he's not on par with Goku and Vegeta's Super Saiyan Blue, but at least not their full power. But I mean, he's pretty damn close, and he still works with them to be able to execute combos and things like that. And to see the three of them charge in, attack together, and shoot blast together, this amazing shot of Goku and Vegeta doing Gallic Gun and Kamehameha, that was the highlight of this episode for me. I really enjoyed this. It was super refreshing. And to see Gohan step up with this awesome Kamehameha to blast off the fusion of the three robots was very satisfying. I really enjoyed that. And there was even one part in the episode where Gohan is blasting with the Kamehameha and he's really pushing himself. And then the camera zooms in right in on his eye. And I was like, oh, give us a glimpse of something, like a peep of Ultra Instinct, like his eye shines silver or shines white or something like that. I was really hoping we'd get something cool like that as a little, you know, foreshadowing of something that could happen for Gohan in the future as far as transformations go, but unfortunately we did not get there. I was really hoping that Gohan would get like a Super Saiyan White in this tournament, but I seriously doubt he's getting any transformations. I think they're pretty much done with transformations, except for maybe Vegeta for the rest of the Tournament of Power. And actually, this episode moved a lot faster than I thought it would, and I thought that they were going to give Universe 3 the Universe 4 treatment and just, you know, basically annihilate everybody in one episode, which technically they did, but as we found out at the end of the episode, there is some secret plan coming out. This new monstrous looking guy named Annie Raza, which is a four-way fusion, will be coming. Pepperoni does say something interesting, that this fusion basically is going to cost him his life, or it could cost him his life. So I don't know how this guy is going to fuse with them. Maybe it's something like the movie 7, where just those parts, you know, sucked into Android 13 and then he transformed into the Super Android 13, the total beast that just wrecked everybody. Maybe it's something like that. I'm not really sure how they're going to fuse into Annie Raza. Like, how do these guys all merge together? I mean, one, you have like a humanoid and a fused three robots. It doesn't look anything like Annie Raza, but we'll find that out next week. But you guys can always leave your comments below as to how you think that they're going to fuse. So there is only 10 minutes remaining in the Tournament of Power, and they moved another 2 minutes. So it looks like this next episode, I'm assuming that Universe 3 will be erased, although we didn't hear anything about that in spoilers. Usually we get told when our universes are getting erased, same with when characters on Universe 7 are going to get knocked out. But we haven't heard anything about either of those in the multiple spoilers that we got for episode 121. But I think that after episode 121, we'll probably be down to 8 minutes, and there's only going to be the two universes left, Universe 7 and 11, which, by the way, when they zoom in on the Pride Troopers and Topo's just sitting there posing, I was cracking up. Like, why is he posing like that just for the camera? He's taking all that spotlight. Yeah, I thought that was funny. But in terms of overall rating for this episode, I'd probably give it something like an 8 or a 9. I mean, I thought it was really solid. It was just an all-around solid episode. The only thing I didn't like about this episode was that they just made these three robots really strong all of a sudden when they already got their butts kicked by Caulifla in her base form, and now they're like, you know, putting pressure on everybody, and you know, Goku and Vegeta are like taking blasts and like grunting like it hurts and stuff. It's like, come on, these guys are total weaklings. I mean, maybe I could understand the fusion because that's how, you know, robots work in Dragon Ball, especially when they merge and things like that. They get like even like a million times stronger. But regardless, they've still lost, technically, I guess, by the end of this episode. So I'm happy it moved fast there. But I'm really excited about the next episode. I really, really love the character design for Annie Raza. I'm excited to learn his story. And I'm wondering, I mean, he looks like a serious threat in this next episode. So I'm wondering, maybe he knocks out Android 18 or potentially some others as well. I could see some people from Universe 7 losing to this guy because he looks ridiculous. But I'll be doing my episode 121 preview video breakdown tomorrow, fellas, so I'm not going to talk about it too much here. And that's all I got, guys. If you guys didn't know, they announced the Dragon Ball Super 2018 movie yesterday. Big video on that. I'll put that at the end of this video. If you guys didn't see it, make sure you go check it out and get the information, because it's looking like it's going to be a very hype movie. Could be about Yamoshi. We don't really know yet, but I'm excited. We should get some trailer footage and things like that very soon. All right, fellas, that's it it for me. Thanks for stopping by for the review today. Have a wonderful weekend, and I'm going to be hitting you guys in about a week with two monster videos coming to Mastar Media. More on that coming soon.